You've now learned a lot about Elastic Jobs. What you haven't seen is how to create them using good old-fashioned T-SQL. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, my name is Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined once again by Kate Smith, a program manager on the Azure SQL team. Thanks for being with us again.
Excited.
And today, we're going to continue our discussion on Elastic Jobs. Now, we've talked about what these are and what's important when you create them, so be sure to check out those videos if you haven't seen them yet. They'll be in the description in a link. And in this video, we're going to see how you can actually create those Elastic Jobs using good old-fashioned T-SQL.
Absolutely.
And so, you know, why don't we just go ahead and get right into it, Kate?
Sure, absolutely. So just to recap, you may have seen our PowerShell video, but in case you didn't, I created a resource group that has a server that will host our database that hosts our Elastic Job Agent, and then two different target servers that we will execute the Elastic Jobs against. 1A and 1B are individual databases in target one, and 2A and 2 exclude our databases in target 2. We plan to target the specific databases of 1A, 1B, and 2A, and we hope to see target 2 excluded when we execute our job. So there is no T-SQL way to create an Elastic Job agent through T-SQL. So we need to create it in the portal. So let's go back to home, go to Elastic Job Agents, right there. We want to add one, and we want to call it the T-SQL Demo Agent. And then we need it to go onto a server. I said I had already created one. Ah, here it is. Elastic Job Agent server, and then we've got this database. Okay, so here we are. We're creating Elastic Job Agent called T-SQL Demo Agent, and we're creating it on the server we created on the database that we created to host it. So let's click OK. Yep, T-SQL Demo Agent, our subscription, and then that. So let's go ahead and create. Awesome. So now we've created our Elastic Job Agent in the portal. Great. So the next thing we want to do is create some credentials. Let's cut away. Let me create the credentials, and then we'll come back to it when it's time to create the target group. So I have created my credentials, and now I'm going to go ahead and create a demo group. So I'm going to add a target group, and this one I have called T-SQL Demo Group. So there it goes. And then we're going to add our server target one into T-SQL Demo Group. It is a SQL server. We have our refresh credential already created. And then we'll go ahead and we'll do the same thing for target two. That's all that's changed. And then we want to exclude the one database. So let's add the command to exclude the excludable exclusion database. Right here, demo group, exclude this particular database on this server. That's its name. And we go ahead and execute that. Great. So if we want to view the recently created target group, we can execute this command and see what we get. Awesome. So now we want to see what our target group is and make sure that it has been created. And here it is. There's our target group. There's its ID. And then we can even look and drill down into the contents of that by executing select target group members. And we get two servers that are included and one that is excluded, that's a specific database. which looks right to me. So, great. Now that we've got our target group defined, it's time to create a job. So we will add this job. We'll call it T-SQL demo with that very illustrious description. The T-SQL that we're going to be using, I'm going to just pull that out and show it to you here, is we're creating a table. We'll create a table S if it doesn't already exist. It's very important to add this if not exist portion to the query because executing this multiple times in a row could cause a failure. That would make it not idempotent, which, as I have discussed in a previous video, is essential for making Elastic Jobs commands work smoothly. So let's take that T-SQL and let's put it into adding a job step. We're going to reference the job name that already exists. We've got our job credential. There's the T-SQL we discussed with properly escaped characters and our T-SQL demo group. Awesome. So now we can query our jobs. And we can see that we are in version 1, it has never run, et cetera. Awesome. So there we did it. We created a job, and we can see it present in our agent host database, and we're ready to run them. So stay tuned for the next video.
Awesome. Thanks, Kate. You know, I had a few questions while you were going through this. Yeah. It's really interesting and it's really cool to see how you can do it in both PowerShell and T-SQL. Yep. My first question, which is really neither here nor there, is, you know, when you create this, it looks like you created it at a server level to include databases, but then you also at a database level chose to exclude databases.
Yes.
Could I also create just at a database level an agent job or Elastic job?
When I defined the demo group previously, so let me bring this command back up and display it. So here, when I defined this command previously to add this database, this specific database to this group, I could have chosen instead to put include here, and it could have been a totally different server. So you could do this with just a new server, with just a single database that you want to include, and just include a single database. Absolutely.
Awesome. Cool. Thanks, Kate. It's really interesting because it's nice because it seems like we have the flexibility to kind of run these jobs on the exact servers and databases, excluding or including whichever really is the easier option. So
yes,
that's pretty cool.
Yes, it's incredibly powerful.
And the second question I have is, now we've seen it in PowerShell and T-SQL, you know, are there advantages to using T-SQL, or is it more of just a preference thing?
I would say, it's mostly a preference thing. The big advantage to T-SQL is if it's what you're familiar with, if it's what you're used to doing, and it's how you're used to interacting with databases, that's available, and it's easy to do that way. It's more of a user-friendly for particularly getting started, people who aren't familiar with or comfortable with the PowerShell portion.
Awesome, cool. So it seems like it's really kind of up to you. You're going to get just about the same functionality with, you know, a few exceptions, like you have to create something in the portal if you're going to use T-SQL.
Yes.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thanks so much, Kate, for being on the show. And, you know, that's not it for Elastic Jobs. You know, now we have a job with a single step. And in the next video, we'll learn about how to schedule these jobs, how to monitor these jobs, and maybe even multi-step jobs. We'll see what we get to. So thanks so much, Kate. And if you like this video, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.